Sesame Street, the story of The Princesses and the Bus, starring Gina as the narrator, Zoe and Lexine as the princesses, with a special appearance by Bob as the little red boat and two other parts as well, and last but not least, starring Telly as the Bus. We'll begin our story in just a moment, but first... Now, the story of The Princesses and the Bus.
Once upon a time, in a faraway kingdom, there lived two clever and lovely young princesses and a nice young bus. The young bus loved giving people rides each day.
Bye-bye. Thanks for the ride, Mr. Bus.
Oh, you're very welcome.
So
drive safely.
Yeah, and thanks for the
See
exact change. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well, I guess it's time to go home to my garage for some rest. I'll just warm up my engine and be on my way.
Well, one day, just as the young bus was ready to head home to his garage, who should happen to wander by but the two princesses? The princesses had been shopping at the Royal Mall, and now they had a problem.
Princess, we have a problem. We need to go home to our palace.
Oh, that's right, Princess. We need to go home, but with all those packages, it's too far to walk.
Wait, look, there's a bus stop sign, and right next to it is a nice-looking young bus.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Would you hop at that nice-looking young bus? We'll give us a ride home. Mr. Bus, we are two young princesses. Will you take us home?
Princesses? Wow, I'd be proud to take you home. Where do you live?
Oh, well, that's easy to explain. We have a map to show you where we live. Princess, show him the first part of our map. See? You just drive along the Royal Road till you get to the shore of Lake Wanaswimma.
The shore of Lake Wanaswimma? Oh, I know how to get there. I'll be happy to take you to the shore of Lake Wanaswimma.
Well, our palace isn't exactly on the shore of Lake Wanaswimma.
It's not?
No, not exactly. You see, to get to our palace, you have to go across the lake to the other side.
Across the lake to the other side?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Across Lake Wanaswimma? But, oh, no. This is awful.
What's wrong?
Well, I'm just a bus. Buses can't swim. Buses can't go across lakes. Oh, this is terrible. If I can't carry you across the lake, you'll never get home. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sad.
But Mr. Bus?
So sad. Wait a minute. Don't worry. Do not worry. I am a smart young bus. I'll think of something. I'll figure out a way to get you across Lake Wanaswimma. Ah, yes. I have an idea. Stay right here. I'll be right back.
But Mr. Bus!
So the young bus hurried off, leaving the two princesses to wonder...
Gee, I wonder how he thinks he's going to get us across Lake Wanaswimma.
We'll find out in just a few minutes when we return to the story of The Princesses and the Bus. And now, back to the next part of The Princesses and the Bus.
The princesses wanted very badly to go home to their palace on the other side of Lake Wanaswimma. Well, they didn't have to wait very long until the nice young bus returned.
Princesses! Princesses, I did it! I figured out how to get you across Lake Wanaswimma.
But Mr. Bus...
Look, I brought a friend of mine to help. Everybody say hello to my pal, the Little Red Boat.
Hiya, everybody. I'm a Little Red Boat. And I have oars. And I have a life preserver, too. And I'd be happy to carry you across Lake Wanaswimma.
Well, that's very nice, Mr. Little Red Boat. But we princesses were going to have this nice young bus take us home.
But your home is across the lake. A bus can't float across the water. Only a boat can do that.
And here I am.
But we don't need a boat.
How can you get to the other side of the lake without a boat?
Well, we can drive over a bridge. show him the next part of our map.
Wow, look at that map. There's a bridge that goes across the lake.
It's called the Lake Wanasuma Bridge, and you can drive over it.
I can drive over the bridge?
Yeah.
Wow, this is great. Now I'll be able to drive you home after all.
Well, gee, if there's a bridge, I guess you won't be needing me.
Thanks anyway, Little Red Boat.
You're welcome. Well, so long, everybody, and have a nice trip. Sometimes they need a little boat, and sometimes they don't.
Okay, princesses, let's go. I'll take you to your palace, right on the other side of the Lake Wanasuma Bridge.
Wait. I don't want to make things hard. But you see, Mr. Bus, our palace isn't exactly right on the other side of Lake Wanasuma.
It's not?
Uh-uh. You see, right on the other side of Lake Wanasuma is a big mountain called Mount Neverclimb. Our palace is on the other side of Mount Neverclimb.
On the other side of Mount Neverclimb? But, oh no, this is terrible.
Well, what's wrong now?
I am just a young bus. I'll never be able to make it to the top of a big mountain like Mount Neverclimb. I'm not strong enough.
Oh,
now I'll never, ever be able to take you home. Oh, I'm so sad.
But, Mr. Bus.
So sad. But don't worry, I am a smart young bus. I'll figure out a way to get you to the other side of Mount Neverclimb. Yes! I already have an idea. Don't move. I'll be right back.
But Mr. Bus!
So the young bus hurried off, leaving the two princesses to wonder.
I wonder how he thinks he's going to get us to the other side of Mount Neverclimb.
Beats me.
We'll find out when we return to the story of The Princesses and the Bus. And now, back to the next part of The Princesses and the Bus.
Well, the princesses who wanted to go home to the other side of Mount Neverclimb didn't have to wait long before the young bus returned.
I did it, princesses! I figured out a way to get you to the other side of Mount Neverclimb.
But, Mr. Bus...
I brought another friend. Say hello to my pal, the Little Red Plane.
Hiya, everybody. I'm a little red plane, and I have wings, and I have a propeller, too. And I'd be happy to fly you over the top of Mount Neverclimb and home to your palace.
Oh, well, that's very nice of you, Mr. Little Red Plane, but we were going to ride with this nice young bus, if you don't mind.
But I'm not strong enough to drive over the top of a mountain as tall as Mount Neverclimb.
Yes, but you don't need to drive us all the way to the top of Mount Neverclimb.
I don't?
No, you don't. See, just look at the next part of our map, princess. See? There's a road that goes around the mountain.
A road?
Yes, so you don't need to drive all the way to the top of the mountain. You can drive around it.
Wow, that's great. I'll be able to drive you home after all.
Well, gee, if there's a road around the mountain, I guess you won't be needing me.
Well, thanks anyway, Little Red Plane. I really appreciate it.
You're welcome. Well, so long, everybody, and have a nice trip. Sometimes they need a plane, and sometimes they don't.
Okay, princesses, if your palace is right on the other side of Mount Neverclimb, well, then you can ride with me all the way home.
Well, that's exactly where our palace is.
No more lakes or rivers, right? No more mountains or jungles or anything else we'll have to cross?
Nope. Our palace is right there on the other side of Mount Neverclimb.
Well, great. Then let's go.
There's only one more thing. It's a pretty long ride. We might get hungry for a healthy snack on the way.
Good idea.
A healthy snack? A healthy snack? Aha! Am I a smart young bus or what? Don't worry about a thing. I will be right back.
I wonder what he's going to do now.
Me too. But I bet we find out when we return to our story in just a few minutes.
And now, finally, the last part of our story, the princesses and the bus.
Well, the princesses were ready to go home to their palace, except for one thing. They wanted a healthy snack to eat on the way. Well, needless to say, it wasn't long before the young bus returned.
This is it! I did it! You want a healthy snack to eat on the way home? Well, I got you a healthy snack to eat on the way home.
Wow, look at that!
You met my friend, the little red boat. You met my pal, the little red plane. Well, say hello to my buddy, the big orange carrot.
Hiya, everybody!
Hi there. You look delicious.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, everybody, get in. It's time to ride home to the palace.
Don't forget the packages.
There you go.
Sometimes you need a carrot, sometimes you don't. Today, I'm needed by princesses who want a healthy snack on their ride home after a hard day.
And so everyone got in the bus and had a happy trip home. Ladies and gentlemen and boys and girls, thanks so much for joining us today for the story of the Princesses and the Bus.
Well, Gina, I think I'll maybe change out of this costume.
Oh, you know? I thoroughly enjoyed your performances, Bob. You were great as the little red boat, and you were terrific as the little red plane. But you know what? You were absolutely fantastic as the big red carrot.
Yeah, really?
Beautiful.
Oh, well, thank you.
Bravo. I have never seen a carrot act so well.
Well, I don't know if I was that good or not, but thank you. I appreciate it. It was really, really fun.
Is that not the most beautiful carrot I have ever seen in my life?
The bus was great.
Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah.
Mr. Rabbit, Princess Bob, please.
You're not a carrot.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
You're a Bob. What's wrong with you? I thought you were a lunch.
Impersonating a carrot, you should be ashamed of yourself.
No.
Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letter Y. And by the number 2.
Coming soon on Sesame Street.
It's cracking. Look, it's a baby honker being born.
Toodaloo!
Funding for Sesame Street is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.